Everything coming out of Apple is so polished, and you would think that the buying experience for a new MacBook would be just as tailored to Apple's pursuit of perfection. But my experience purchasing a new 16-inch MacBook Pro M3 Max laptop didn't live up to that expectation. But there is more to the story. We're gonna talk about my experience and help you better understand the best Mac for you right here, right now on Robeytech. Now, this is not a review or a sensational expose. I just need to share my experience and untangle the confusion that I went through buying this beautiful 16-inch MacBook Pro. This video is going to be a full course meal, so if you want to skip to the soup and tea courses and get right to the meat and potatoes of how to choose the right MacBook for you, we're gonna add timestamps to make that happen. And in fact, we've got this cool little thing that our editors do that's right over here that just, it's going along with the video. Okay, to start off, let me give you two pieces of context. First off, I am a complete noob when it comes to MacBooks. Look, even Brian makes fun of me, Damien made fun of me, everybody was just like, you don't know how to buy a Mac. Well, neither do they. So this is my first real attempt in trying to figure out the right one for me, or for anyone for that matter. Secondly, it's a really exciting time for laptops right now. With Lunar Lake and Strix Point on the horizon from both Intel and AMD, and the recent release of Snapdragon laptops from Qualcomm, it felt like a really great time to jump in and understand the entire landscape, including these bad boys, of modern laptops. And since I have been enjoying testing, reviewing, and using all the laptops we've been covering lately, that also meant getting in on the magic of a little fruit company from California. It's not really little anymore, right? Like, it's kind of like a juggernaut. Now, there has actually been a huge divide between these two platforms. Mac laptops get insane battery life while pushing very specific powerhouse applications, while Windows laptops had incredible performance in applications and gaming, but weren't so stellar with battery life. With the advent of new AMD and Intel, plus Qualcomm mobile CPUs and Apple Silicon, the gap is closing to the point where we're seeing better battery life from Windows laptops and more performance from MacBooks. So when you look at what's happening in the laptop space and the diversity of laptops in front of you here, these two worlds are merging, and the lines between which system is best for you is actually getting a little bit blurrier. With all that in mind, it was finally time for me to do the unthinkable. I was really gonna buy a Mac to help me understand just how much the divide had changed and really get to experience macOS for the first time. As I started making plans, I knew that I had to give it an honest try. I had to commit to spending at least 3 weeks, if not more, using my new MacBook exclusively to really get that authentic user experience. But this would mean that I would need a laptop that could handle all my productivity tasks. It had to be able to do some gaming because of taking it to travel, and I needed to jump in on the photo editing or video editing. Yeah, don't laugh. It may happen if it popped up and I needed to for the channel, like if like Connor died or Brian got an aneurysm or they left me for somebody else. It could happen. Don't leave me, guys. Now on the Windows side, I could look at any set of specs based on a CPU and GPU, discrete or integrated, and very easily tell you what experience would be for any of the things that you gave me based on the combinations of hardware, whether that was productivity, whether that was gaming, whether that was video editing. Like, you just say, hey, 4060, you know, 13600K. 9700X and 4080. You know, like, I could easily say, oh, well, here's how your experience is gonna be like. So if I was buying a Windows-based laptop that could do everything I mentioned, I would say either like a Core Ultra 7 or a Ryzen 7 AI chip with an RTX 4070 or higher. That would cost you around $1,500 to $2,000 depending on the screen quality, storage, and other ancillary features you wanted. Pretty straightforward for me at least, and I'd love to know down in the comments if you think so as well. Like, how easy is it for you to choose a Windows laptop? I feel like it's pretty straightforward, but I'd love to know your thoughts. So I began to do my research and I watched some YouTube videos on gaming on a Mac, including reviews on the M3 and the MacBook from MKBHD. I saw iJustine, I watched a ton of ones on gaming. So then I started poking around at how much I would need to spend to replace my ideal Windows travel laptop, the Asus ROG Zephyrus G16. And this is where the problems kind of began. I mean, outside of knowing that the MacBook Air was lighter than the MacBook Pro, and the MacBook Pro had the M3 Pro and the M3 Max, it became really hard to understand which chips would provide what kind of experience, especially for gaming. I know people are laughing at me already. They're like, it's not, guys, it's not just gaming, it's everything else, but that was a critical part of what I wanted to do here. And let's be honest, it has been a focus for Apple. This should be something I could figure out, right? After floundering around a bit on Twitter and on YouTube, I decided that the MacBook Pro looked to be the right choice for me, at least that's what all the signs pointed to. Now, I knew that Apple had a secret weapon to help unravel my confusion, the Apple Store. From what I understood, this is their gold standard for a consumer experience. I've been there a number of times getting my iPad, my iPhone, my Apple TV, and each of these experiences had been absolutely fine. But I then realized I knew exactly what I wanted before I even went into the store. This time, however, I had questions and I was looking forward to getting answers from the world famous Apple geniuses. Now, to be very clear here, I was expecting to walk in and get all the answers I needed because I really believed the Apple Store employees had all the Apple answers to help me out. Boy, was I wrong. It started out promising enough. I told the smiling Apple employee what I wanted and how I was going to use the device. He asked politely if I wouldn't mind taking a quick survey to answer some questions. This would narrow down the options, which should help me decide. That sounded perfect. I scanned a QR code that led me to a survey, like the one that you're seeing here, but much shorter. Which Mac is best for you? Honestly, the online survey that's on the website actually included games as a use case, but the one that I took in the store didn't, because he actually told me to select other uses option, and he actually wasn't really surprised it wasn't on there. Little did he know that on the online version it was. Now, in the case of the survey I took, it showed me three options in order of cost, and based on the CPU models, I could either choose the M3, the M3 Pro, or the M3 Max. Pretty much their entire library was an option. I'm not sure how that was actually supposed to be all that helpful. Even if the one that we're showing here, which is showing you the online options, if you look at the product highlights based on your answers, it's very generic. And do I not get ray tracing if I get an M3, but I do get it if I get an M3 Pro? How are apps going to run and which ones are going to run best? What do I lose out on if I get the M3 versus the M3 Max? What will my applications be like, and what about gaming? These didn't feel like difficult questions, and I needed answers to make the experience as successful as possible. I mean, I really wanted to do this experiment. Unfortunately, when it came down to the meat and potatoes, no one in the store could really tell me what the difference between the M3, the M3 Pro, and M3 Max were, other than one was faster than the one before, it had more cores, and way more memory throughput. I kid you not, there's one guy who just said, look at the memory throughput, like for 5 minutes. And I was like, this is not helping me. I mean, I was very polite about it, but I was like, this is not helping me. Now, throughout the experience, I didn't hide that I'm a pretty technical guy, but I felt like I was being shown the engine of a car without any context for how the driving experience was actually gonna be. Now, I wanna be very clear. Don't go brigading or review bombing your nearest Apple Store. The people are actually awesome. Everyone at the Apple Store was very nice, and they tried very hard to help me. It was actually great customer service, and we were in the store a full 15 minutes past closing as they tried to help me figure out the best MacBook Pro for me. I have to give them props where they were due, and they went above and beyond, and they were very clear that I could return this no questions asked if I wasn't happy with my experience. So I guess you do have a trial period. I really do appreciate their honesty throughout the process. Even though they couldn't help me, they agreed with me, and they said they weren't trading for these kind of things, which, I mean, thanks for the honesty, but it blew my mind because there were lots of people there buying MacBooks. I mean, how the heck did they know what they wanted while I felt like I was in the dark after making my purchase? So I ended up buying a 14-inch MacBook Pro with the M3 Pro chip, but I really didn't feel like I had the best product for what I needed. Instead of coming away more confident, I kind of felt less so. Something was just gnawing at me that for gaming, I was really going to need an M3 Max. So I went home with my shiny new $2,400 toy, jumping back on the internet, and started the research all over again. The next day, I grabbed the unopened bag, unopened box with my MacBook Pro and made my way back to the Apple Store for another round of which Mac should I buy? And the experience was very much the same. In fact, this time the Apple employees engaged me far less. Now, to be fair, it was busier and they knew they couldn't really answer my questions and they kind of left me alone. So there I was, picking up and holding both a 16-inch and a 14-inch MacBook Pro, knowing I probably needed to buy the M3 Max. Now, what I also discovered, because weight was gonna matter to me and I was carrying them around, is that the difference between the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook is actually 1.2 pounds, which makes way more sense than the 0.2 pounds that I was actually told by the Apple employee. Because I was like, oh man, it's only a 0.2 pound difference. This is completely fine. And he was like, yeah, it is. It wasn't. That's a problem. So when it was all said and done, for everything I needed the laptop to do, this was the right call. It just took a long time to get there. So here I am, $4,000 lighter, which it was digital money, so it didn't make a difference. It still weighed the same. It was 1.2 pounds heavier than I expected, with a MacBook Pro's M16 with an M3 Max. And that's what we have right here. Now, while their kindness and customer engagement was awesome, the whole Apple Store experience left me really disappointed and frustrated. Now, as I was writing out this experience, I was still really conflicted about all of this and whether or not to share it here on Robeytech. But while I was interacting with a bunch of you on Twitter, I was surprised to learn that my experience wasn't a surprise to folks, that they couldn't answer my questions. Now, hyperbole and online interactions are one thing, But then I remembered that at least two members of the Robeytech team both had experience buying Macs and seemed largely unbothered by their experiences. Tom, the mastermind behind Robeytech.com and our Robeytech deals, gave me some incredible insights on purchasing a Mac and even pointed me to a resource that I'm going to share with you in just a little bit. And finally, Damien, who's our scriptwriter, meme curator, and asker of so many questions, has been a lifelong Mac user, and he actually went to an Apple store to see if he could replicate my experience. As for Damien's experience, it was actually wildly different. He got paired with an Apple Store employee who understood the system demands of content creation. He was very candid about the current limitations of gaming on Mac, and he directed Damien to the right laptop on the first try. He even helped explain the differences in the M3 processors as being based more on the CPU and GPU core counts, as well as memory throughput rather than clock speeds or mega transfers. And to be very clear here, we have it on good authority that Apple employees don't get commission on upselling folks. So there was zero benefit to pushing the Macs. The conversation and the use of the device naturally just kind of led there. After Damien and I compared notes about the experience, he said that he was pretty convinced he'd be back to that store specifically if he ever decided to buy another MacBook. That's a lot of context here, and because we don't want this to happen to you, we want to provide you with some helpful tools. So outside of Apple's survey that we showed you earlier, you can look at sites like Best Buy, which will give you a ballpark of what kind of things you can expect to do with a MacBook. So let's just take a step back from Apple here and look at the new Microsoft Surface laptop powered by Snapdragon. I mean, this is super clear. It shows that it's great for productivity, gaming is gonna be meh, and it could do video and photo editing if it needs to. Best Buy will let you do that with MacBooks too, to give you a quick at-the-glance idea of what you're gonna get with the laptops you're considering. I wish Apple kinda did that. Now as we get deeper into the world of Mac, we will give you more detailed information and go way more in depth with our own information later on. But here is a light guide to help you choose the right MacBook for you in regards to Apple Silicon models. To help us out, we're gonna be showing you insights from an article at Medium that make this a whole lot clearer. I mean, I wanna give them credit because this would have made my buying experience way better. If battery life is your goal, then any of the three chips will work. In fact, the difference across the models for battery life is actually pretty close. The difference at a high level between the M3, the M3 Pro, and M3 Max chips are the number of cores for the CPU and GPU. M3 has 8 cores and 10 GPU cores, M3 Pro has 12 CPU cores and 18 GPU cores, and then there's the M3 Max that either has 14 or 16 CPU cores and either 30 or 40 GPU cores. Another thing that is different between the three models, which surprised me, is the speed of the actual drives. This is super important if you want to do any high performance computing like AI, machine learning, gaming, AR, VR, or applications like CAD. For single core applications, all three machines will actually perform at a similar level. So if you're doing basic computing tasks like browsing the web, email, or your basic productivity, then the M3 is going to be totally fine. Multi-core is a whole other beast, and this is where the Max is going to shine. When you look at things like coding, large language models, photo editing, and any other high compute productivity task that'll spend time waiting on your MacBook to do the thing you want it to do, multi-core can make or break your experience. In many cases, the jump from M3 to M3 Max will literally half your wait time to do things like compile code, render videos, and dealing with larger, more complex photos, videos, and more. The one rule of thumb here is the M3 Pro will be about 20% better on average versus the M3 at all of these things. So you need to decide if 20% is enough or if you're gonna need closer to 50%. If you're at the cutting edge, the M3 Max is going to be your only option with 3D modeling, game engine work, and machine learning, which need the best of the best. And then finally for gaming, we have to put the M3 cores into a similar category as AMD or Intel's chips with integrated GPUs. If you want the best gaming experience on a MacBook, be prepared to shell out a lot of money for the M3 Max to push goodish frame rates. Looking at the data, you're talking about 120 frames per second on Shadow of the Tomb Raider on M3 Max, while the M3 Pro is only pulling 48 and only 33 on the M3. On games like Borderlands 3, the Max couldn't even hold a solid 60 frames per second. Now this may have changed, but it's clear that the Max is not going to compete with a discrete GPU like the NVIDIA RTX 4070, 4080, or 4090 mobile chips. That being said, gaming looks far more promising on a Mac today than it has for a while. But I say looks far more promising because I've only tried a little of it myself. As we wrap this up, I just want to say one more time, I actually really appreciated the customer care experience we had at the Apple Store as we visited. Even though the experience left me a bit confused on how people who want to buy a Mac can make a truly informed decision based on Apple's tools. Hopefully, we've been able to provide you with a few more tools for your toolbox before you go Apple picking for yourself. I know I have a lot to learn already. And I've got to say, it's an exciting time for laptops, including the MacBooks, and we want to ensure that you get as complete of a picture as you can right here on Robeytech. But what did you think of this? Were you surprised by my experience? What would you have done differently? I'd love to know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this right here on Robeytech. And if you're in the PC world or even entering the MacBook world, join our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Maybe you can be the expert for us, and you might make a PC friend, and I think the world's mind might just blow up if that were to actually happen. Also, you can follow us on all the socials right here at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video. Look forward to seeing you on the next one.